MSP 430 interrupts and processing of interrupts. First, interrupts means disturbance. That means an external task informs to the CPU that is waiting for CPU. That is called interrupt. Interrupt means an external task informs to the CPU that an external task is waiting for CPU. After interrupt occurs, that suspend the currently executing task and store the next instruction address into the stack register and go to the interrupt vector table. Interrupt vector table is a memory location which keeps the address of the ISRs. ISR means interrupt service routine. Interrupt service routine means the program associated around an interrupt is called interrupt service routine. After interrupt occurs, which suspend the current execution and store the next instruction address into the stack register. Next, go to the interrupt vector table and get the address of the ISR and go to the ISR address. So in the ISR address, it will execute all ISR instructions. Next, after completion of execution of instructions, which executes the RETI, that indicates return from interrupt, then go to the stack register, pop the program counter where that contains the next instruction address, then execute the main program as usual. Like that, MSP430 executes the interrupts. So example, so here we can write a C program on MSP430 to configure port 2 pin 1 as an interrupt pin. Interrupt from the falling edge interrupt. So for that, first we need to select port 2 and pin 1 as the special function register. That means we need to give 1. Then we need to enable the interrupts and clear the previous interrupt values. Next, whenever interrupt occurs, that pin value is 1. That is the flow chart we need to write here. For that, first hash include msp430.h. It is a library file specific to the msp430. Next, void main, that indicates the start of the program. Next, stop the watchdog timer to avoid the resetting the system for every 32 milliseconds. For that, by giving the password to that one, we can give hold value to the control pin. That means we are stopping the watchdog timer. Next, we need to select port 2 pin 1 as the special function, that is interrupt function. For that, we can use the instruction p2sel, that indicates the port 2 select equal to port 2 select vertical strip bit 1. So that means we are giving one value to the pin 1. That means one indicates special function, that is interrupt pin. If you are giving 0, that is GPIO pin. Because we need to operate as interrupt pin, we are giving 1 here. Next, we need to enable the interrupt. For that, we are using P2IE. IE means interrupt enable. So we are enabling the interrupt in the P2.1. So port P2IE equal to P2IE vertical strip bit 1. We are enabling the, for enabling we are giving 1, for disabling 0. by default it in disable condition. Whenever we are giving 1 to the P2.1, that will be enabled. Interrupt will be enabled in the P2.1. Next, so interrupt occurred in the falling edge. So we need to define the here. So port 2, interrupt edge select, IES means interrupt edge select. So port P2IES equal to P2IES vertical strip bit 1. So if you are giving 1, that interrupt occurred at the falling edge. Next, so we are defining the P2.1 as the interrupt pin, enable the interrupts at the P2.1, and we are defining the falling edge interrupts. Next, we need to clear the previous values. For that, P2IFG interrupt flag equal to P2IFG and complement bit 1, means we are giving 0 to the P2.1. That means if any previous values is in the flag register, that will be clear. Next, while off 1 means always true. So this function, it will check the every time. Next, if P2IFG and bit 1, that means port 2.1, pin port 2.1 is 1. Do something, whatever the operation you want to, whenever interrupt, whatever you want to do, we can define here. Then, so function is closed, next is closed. So like that, we are defining the port 2.1 as the interrupt pin at the falling edge.